Hello, Kingsgate Club. I am the music man, Tom Hicks. I hope and pray that everybody is in good health and spirits during this period of time. I'm inviting you to all sit down with your family at home and enjoy a little bit of time in the world of music. Some friends of yours and mine have spent some time producing a podcast of music created from the Music of the Decades concerts that I did during the season. The music man Tom Hicks at the organ, Don Richmond doing graphics, Ren McMahon's doing the publishing, Jan Anderson and Brian Bolt both on audio during the concert. We will be placing all five videos up on the website for you to see and hear at will, whenever you have time to sit down and relax with your family. We have the video, music from the 20s, ready to go. In the 20s, the 30s, 40s, 50s, and 60s will follow one every week. We will notify you on cable news and the newsletter when the videos will be posted. We hope that you enjoy these videos as much as we have enjoyed doing them. Thanks, the music man Tom Hicks and friends. This video was produced for the sole purposes of helping to ease the blues of being restricted at home while we all fight this virus together. Thank you very much and enjoy the music.
Good evening, everyone. Thank you for coming to my concert titled Songs of the Decades. I am the music man, Tom Hicks, and I'm going to reintroduce you to the songs of the 20s through the 60s in several different concerts during the season. Before we get into the great music of the 40s, let me tell you about this wonderful gift we have right here. This is a Sterling Lowry organ. We do not call this organ anymore an organ. It's actually a virtual orchestra, where it can play every instrument in a full-size orchestra. Let's start off with a very popular song. It's very apropos right now, a little late, but apropos. White Christmas. It is a song written by Irving Berlin in 1940, reminiscing about an old-fashioned Christmas setting. This was sung by Bing Crosby, which now is the world's most popular rendition. It is estimated that it sold in excess of 50 million copies worldwide. When the figures were all put together, the versions of everybody else were added up, it turned out to be over 100 million copies of the same song. The first public performance was Bing Crosby on his NBC radio show, see if you remember this, the Kraft Music Hall, on Christmas Day, 1941. I'm doing this song with a little doo-wop. This is a version to jazz up the song a little. I hope you do enjoy that version of it.
Do, 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 do
Did you like that version of it? It's a little different. Music of the 40s was built around jazz and the big band styles that were popular. Artists like Rosemary Clooney, Count Basie, Artie Shaw helped to define the music era. This was the era of World War II. Many musicians and musical acts strived to reflect the pain while remaining upbeat and positive about the impending future. The invasion of the solid body guitar by Les Paul in 1941 also influenced the styles that were popular. World War II music and the USO, as it became clear that the United States would enter World War II, patriotism ran high, influenced pop culture, including the music industry. Artists like Andrew Sisters, Bing Crosby, they released songs referring to the military and the war, such as the Andrew Sisters' 1941 hit Boogie Woogie Bugle Boy, and the 1943 hit Shoo Shoo Baby, and Crosby's I'll Be Home for Christmas. Many songs addressed the war directly, like Sammy Kaye's Remember Pearl Harbor from 1942. Big band music, an offshoot of the swing and traditional jazz, was at the height of its popularity during the early 40s. The genre focused on band leaders who often led four-sectional musical ensembles with more than 10 members. The four sections consisted of saxophone, trumpet, and rhythm, piano, bass, drums, and guitar. Big band and swing were somewhat interchangeable terms, as swing was often performed by the big bands. The Dorsey brothers, Tommy and Jimmy, best exemplified the genre, as well as Glenn Miller did. After the war, however, many clubs opted in favor of hiring smaller bands due to the high cost of accommodations and compensation, which led to the disbanding of several of the decade's most popular groups. Latin influence and Latin American music became popular during the decade. Some artists were solo acts, while others were big band scenes in musicals like Tito Puente, Enrico Mantecreua, singers like Carmen Miranda, and band leader Xavier Cugat and Vincent Lopez. The Latin sound was a popular staple of the dance scene, and the samba and mambo were particularly influential during the 1940s. Country western music became quite popular in the 40s. It was previously referred to as hillbilly genre, and then the folks and blues genre, and the music charts until the end of the decade, when it was officially referred to as country western music. The popularity of western films bolstered the genre, and the singing cowboys, film stars such as Roy Rogers, Gene Autry, were also popular recording artists. Some of Gene Autry's biggest hits included Don't Fence Me In and At Mail Call Today from 1945. Styles of country music like honky tonk were also popular during the decade, with artists like Hank Williams, Ernie Tubbs, getting their start in the early 40s. Many mainstream popular artists jumped on the country bandwagon as well as with Bing Crosby, the Andrews Sisters, releasing country songs throughout the decade. Paper Doll was a hit song by the Mills Brothers. In the United States, it held the number one position on the Billboard Singles Chart for 12 weeks, from November 6, 1943, to January 22, 1944. The success of the song represented something of a revival for the group after a few declining sales years. It is one of the fewer than 40 all-time singles to have sold 10 million or more physical copies worldwide. Harry Mills, he recalled that he and his brother Herbert did not like the song, although their brother Donald did. Harry said, "As we kept rehearsing and rehearsing and rehearsing, the song got better. We had a better feeling for the song." Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer was written by songwriter Johnny Marks, based on the 1935 story of Rudolph published by the Montgomery Ward Company. Gene Autry recorded the hit number one on the U.S. charts the week of Christmas, 1949. In 1939, Marks' brother, Robert May, created Rudolph for the Montgomery Ward, and Marks decided to adopt the song Rudolph into his song. Gene Autry rejected the song at first, but his wife convinced him to use it. There's a good wife again. Look at that. The success of the song by Gene Autry gave support to the popular Easter jingle, Here Comes Peter Cottontail. Some of these songs are coming in a little late for Christmas. That's too bad I couldn't play them in December, but they were created in the 40s, so we had to stick to the script. Don't Fence Me In the original written song in 1934 for Adios Argentina. An outproduced 20th Century Fox musical, Don't Fence Me In. It was based on the text by Robert Fletcher, a poet, and an engineer with the Department of Health, a Department of Highway, in Helena, Montana. Cole Porter, who has been asked to write a cowboy song for the 20th Century Fox musical, bought the poem from Fletcher for $250. Porter was credited with sole authorship. Porter wanted to give credit to Fletcher, but the publicist wouldn't allow it. After the song became popular, Fletcher hired an attorney who negotiated his co-authorship credit for future publications. Though it was the most popular song of the time, Porter claimed it was the least one that he liked. Sometimes they don't like successful songs, I guess.
Thank you.
Green Eyes is a popular song originally written in Spanish under the title Those Green Eyes in 1929. The English version of the song was written in 1931 but did not become a hit for 10 more years when recorded by Jimmy Dorsey's orchestra. The recording was made on March 19, 1941, with vocals by Helena Eberle and released by Decca Records. Gloria Jean sang the Spanish version of Green Eyes in the film When Johnny Comes Marching Home. Al Jolson recorded a version titled, get this, S&H Green Stamps. Ben Affleck sang the song in Spanish for the 2006 film Hollywoodland. Frenesi is a music piece originally composed by Albert Dominique for the marimba and adopted as a jazz standard by Lionel Whitecup and others. The word frenesi means frenzy in Spanish. A hit version recorded by Artie Shaw and his orchestra reached number one on the Billboard charts on December 21, 1940, staying there for 13 weeks. This Artie Shaw recording was used in the soundtrack of the film Raging Bull. Thank you. You Are My Sunshine is a song published by Jimmy Davis and Charles Mitchell in 1939. It was declared the state song of Louisiana. It actually started out as a country song and developed out into an American pop culture in 1941. Other artists that have made it popular were Gene Autry, Bing Crosby, John Hurt, Wayne King, and of course, Lawrence Welk. Here's an old favorite you might remember. Don't Sit Under the Apple Tree. This is a popular song that was made famous by Glenn Miller and the Andrews Sisters during World War II. Its lyrics are the words of two lovers who pledged their fidelity while one of them was away serving in the war. The melody was written by Sammy Stepp as an updated version of the 19th century folk song Long, Long Ago. Lou Brown and Charlie Tobias wrote the lyrics, and the song debuted in the 1939 musical Yokel Boy. After the United States entered the war in December of 1941, Brown and Tobias modified the lyrics to the current form, with the chorus ending in "Till I Come Marching Home." The song remained on your hit parade from October 1942 through January 1943. It is the longest period of a war song to hold first place.
Do be
Baby, it's cold outside. Is an Academy Award winning song by Frank Loesser in 1944, which gained wide recognition in 1949 when it was performed in the film Neptune's Daughter. While the lyrics made no mention of holiday, it is usually played around Christmas time. Since 2009, the song faced some criticism for the presumed implication of the lyrics. In 2018, the airing of the song was canceled by the Canadian Broadcasting Company, streaming services to the lyrics, but was later reestablished after public backlash.
I really can't say.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I gotta go away.
Baby, it's cold outside.
Evening has been
hoping that you dropped
so
in.
Very
nice. I'll hold your hands, they're just like
my
mine.
My mother will start to
beautiful,
worry.
What's your
My father
hurry?
Will be pacing the floor.
Listen to that fireplace
roar. You really had better scurry.
Beautiful, please don't hurry.
Maybe just to have a drink more.
I'll put some records on while I
the
pour.
The neighbors might think.
Baby, it's so bad out there.
Say, what's in this drink?
No cabs to be had out there.
I wish I knew how.
Your eyes are like starlight
to
now.
Break this spell.
I'll take your hat.
Well,
your
thank
hair
you.
Looks swell.
I ought to say no, no,
mind
no,
if
so.
I move in
At
closer?
At least I'm gonna say that I tried.
What's the sense of hurting my pride?
I really can't say.
Baby, don't hold out.
Baby, it's cold outside.
I like to think of it as opportunistic.
I simply must go.
Baby, it's cold outside.
The answer is no.
But baby, it's cold outside.
The welcome has been
how lucky that you
so
dropped in.
Nice and warm.
Look out the window at that storm.
My sister will be suspicious.
Pass your lips, look delicious. Waves upon a tropical shore.
My maiden aunt's mind is
yes,
vicious.
Your lips are delicious.
Or maybe just a cigarette more.
Never such a blizzard before.
I gotta get home.
Baby, you'll freeze out there.
Say, lend me your car.
It's up to your knees out there.
You've really been grand.
I feel when I touch your
but
hand.
Don't you see?
How can you do this thing to
There's
me?
There's bound to be talk tomorrow.
Think of my lifelong story.
At least there'll be plenty in play.
If you got
Here's a song you might remember. Buttons and Bows. This was written by Jay Livingston and the lyrics by Ray Evans. The song was published in 1947. The song was written for Bob Hope and Jane Russell in the film Paleface. It won the Academy Award for Best Original Song. The song was reprised in the sequel, Son of Paleface for the Roy Rogers, Jane Russell, and Bob Hope. In 2004, it finished up number 87 in the AFI's 100 Years, 100 Songs.
Thank you.
Besame Mucho is a song written in 1940 by Mexican songwriter Consuelo Velasquez, a famous version sung by Trio Rancho. It is one of the most famous boleros and was recognized in 1999 as the most sung and recorded Mexican song in the world. The song appeared in the film Follow the Boys in May 1944, when it was played by Charles Spivak and his orchestra in Cowboys and Senoritas in 1944, with vocals by Dale Evans. There's a new name for you. When You Wish Upon a Star is a song written by Lee Harleen and Ned Washington for the Walt Disney's 1940 adaptation of Pinocchio. The original version was sung by Cliff Edwards in the character of Jiminy Cricket. This song also won the Academy Award for Best Original Song and was the first song to win an Academy Award for the Disney Corporation.
Thank you.
Cruising Down the River is a 1946 popular song in the UK by two middle-aged women named Ellie Beadle and Nell Tollison. One of the original early recordings of the song issued in the UK in January 1946 on the Columbian Records, which was the biggest recording and sheet music song in the United Kingdom. We here remember Connie Francis in 1959 singing this song. The song was also sung by Dick Hames in 1953 for the film Cruising Down the River. Make you feel like you're out at the ball game? Let It Snow is a song written by Sammy Kahn and composed by Jules Stein in July 1945. It was written in a heat wave in California. Kahn and Stein imagined cooler conditions. It was favored during the Christmas season, but it can be sung during any month of the year. First recorded for RCA in 1945 by Vaughn Monroe. It became a Billboard hit in January out to February 1946. Woody Herman, Johnny Berman, Connie Boswell, they also reached the charts during the same period. Thank you. This is an interesting one you might enjoy. Used to go to the theater on Saturday morning, watch the Cowboys and Indians and the newsreels and a feature film for, what, 12 cents? And they used to play, the organist there would play Linda. Linda is really the name of a one-year-old Linda Eastman. She was the daughter of Jack Lawrence. She turned out to be the first wife of Paul McCartney. Her name was Linda Eastman McCartney. The song was written by Jack Lawrence in the 1942 era while Lawrence was in the service during World War II. Peg of My Heart was a popular song written by Alfred Brand, the words by Fred Fisher. It was published, believe it or not, in March 15, 1913, and it was featured in the 1913 Ziegfeld Follies. The song, first published by Irving Kaufman in 1912 at the College Inn in New York City, after he stumbled across the draft of the song and music on the shelf at Leo Feist's office. The song was inspired by the main character in the very successful Broadway play of Time, Peg of My Heart, that debuted December 20, 1912, at the Court Theater. It later, in 1942, hit the top 100 charts that year. Some Enchanted Evening is a song tune, is a show tune from the 1949 Rodgers and Hammerstein's musical South Pacific. It is the single biggest popular hit to come out of any Rodgers and Hammerstein show. It is a three-verse solo for the male character Emil, in which he describes seeing a stranger, knowing that he will see her again and dreaming of her laughter. He sings that, when you find your true love, you must fly to her and make her your own.
That's all, folks.